Hey guys, this is Tekre sir, and today I'm going to do a mini DIY project using the ESP8266. Basically, this is a Node MCU board and it's a development board for IoT projects. So we are going to make a smart home automation using this chip and few programming, as well as by using few electronic components. So without any further delay, let's get started. First of all, you're going to need this ESP8266 Node MCU board, and the link for this board will be in the description. Again, that will be the Best Buy link. Again, you need a desktop computer with Arduino software installed in it and a few libraries as well as few components. So in my case, we are going to use the LED to simply see the result, but you can connect the relay modules to it, so you can control the heavy appliances or electronic loads through this device. So basically, we are going to control the appliances through Wi-Fi. So this module is going to be connected to the internet through Wi-Fi, your given Wi-Fi, and by using another mobile device, we are going to send the signal to this module to switch on and off the devices connected to it. So that's the simple logic behind, or a simple concept behind this project. So we are going to use the Blink app. We can call it as a free cloud or the service. By using Blink, we are going to basically create this project. So before proceeding with the project, first of all, let's take a look at how to set up this Arduino software in order to flash the sketch onto it. So on your computer, simply launch the Arduino IDE. And we have to download the Blink library, because the library needs to be installed in order to simply upload the sketch. So once the software is opened, simply go to sketch and then go to include library, then click on manage libraries. Now it will open a new prompt, and make sure that you are connected to the internet, because we are going to download the libraries through the internet. Now let it update the existing libraries. So once it has updated, simply go to search bar, type Blink. And let it search, and you will see this result. As you can see, it is already installed on my device, and you have to install this Build a Smartphone app from your project in minutes. So you have to install this library onto your Arduino IDE. So once you have successfully installed this library, we are ready to go, or we are ready to upload the sketch. So once the libraries has been installed, simply go to File, then go to Examples, then simply scroll down until you see Blink here. And in Blink, we have to select Boards Wi-Fi, and in Boards Wi-Fi, we have to select the ESP8266 standalone. So it will open the existing sketch of Blink. So let me just expand this. So this is the existing sketch. So in auth, we have to basically provide our authentication token from the Blink, and in SSID, we have to provide the name of the Wi-Fi network that we are going to connect this module to, and the password of that network if it exists. So let's get back to the mobile and set up the app before uploading the sketch to the Node MCU board. So now on your mobile device, simply download the Blink app from the Google Play Store. Now once you launch the app, you have to first sign in to the Blink, or you have to create an account on the Blink so that it can communicate with you for the token. So once you have created the account on it and you have completed the sign up process, you will be greeted with this screen. So now simply tap on New Project and select here Node MCU, because we are going to use Node MCU board. So once Node MCU, then select the connection type as Wi-Fi and then hit on create. As you can see, it is saying that authentication token is sent to the provided email ID. So simply click on OK and you will receive an email regarding the authentication token. And as you can see, this is our project, and it is an empty project. As you can see, I already received the authentication token. Now simply click on plus, and we can add this type of widgets to design our Blink dashboard. Now you can use any number of buttons that you want until you end up using all the pins on the Node MCU board. So we are going to use 4 pins in this case, so we are going to add 4 of these buttons onto it, as you can see. So guys, once you have imported all the buttons, simply go to first button and just rename the button to whatever you want, and now tap on the pin. Make sure that it is digital and select the pin as D3, because I am going to use D3. You can use any pin that you want, but make sure you remember that pin number. So we have added all the four buttons as you can see. So we are pretty much done with the blink part. As you can see, now we can simply start the project, but it won't connect because we haven't added our device to it. Simply stop the service right for now. So the email has been sent to us regarding the authentication tokens. We have to insert the token here and we have to upload the sketch. So guys, we are back onto our Arduino IDE. So I have already copied down my authentication token, so I will simply paste it over here, and I will also add my credentials or the Wi-Fi credentials over here and password for it. Make sure you type this correct or else the device won't connect to the Wi-Fi network. Now after providing all the credentials and the password and the authentication token as well, we have to simply connect our board to the computer or the laptop using a USB cable. So once your board is connected, simply go to tools, select the COM port which is available there, and choose the board as Node MCU 1.0 ESP12E module, and let all the other things as it is, and simply click on the upload button and it will start compiling the code and it will upload to the Node MCU board. Okay, so it is saying hard resetting via RTS pin, so in that case you can manually reset the Node MCU board as well. So you can see the reset button over here, so you can simply press the reset button. So before that, simply go to tools, then open serial monitor and then click on the reset button over here, and as you can see, it is connecting to the network. So as you can see, it says connected to the Wi-Fi and IP address is also shown, and it is also connected to the Blink Cloud. So we are pretty much 80% done with the project. So now we have to set up few electronics to test the result of the project. So guys, once we are done uploading the sketch onto our Node MCU, now we have to simply connect few LEDs in order to see the result of our project. You can use the relays as well as if you want, but it will be lengthy process, so I'm going to use this LED to demonstrate how it actually works. So as you can see, this is the LED. So we have to connect to D3, D4, D5 and D6 as we have mentioned it in our Blink project that we have created on the device. So now simply connect the positive to the pins and simply ground all these to the ground pin of the Node MCU. So guys, this is how the project actually looks when we have connected the LEDs. As you can see, all the positives are connected to the respective pin numbers and the negatives are connected to the ground of the board. Now we have to simply connect it to a power source in order to just simply boot this board. So as you can see, these two are glowing. Now simply wait for a few seconds. As you can see, now only this blue is glowing and all the fours are turned off. It means that it has connected to the internet and the Blink server as well. So on your phone, simply open the Blink application and let it load the project. As you can see, this is our project, and if we tap on it, as you can see, it's already connected to our project. As you can see, new device and it's online. So let's try to switch on the LED connected to the D3. As you can see, it's turned on. D4, D5, D6, and we can turn these off as well. As you can see, it's completely working super fine. As you can see, we are connected through the mobile data, so let's try to turn these on. As you can see, all the four are working, so it means that you can control these appliances from anywhere you want, irrespective of whether you are on the same network or not. So yeah, this is pretty much it for this video guys. If you found this video really helpful, then do that like button, subscribe button and stay tuned for more such videos. So thank you guys, thanks for watching.